this time to introduce the 2023 Otterbein Summer Chorale. Thank you.
come together to make this choir, to just have a chance to sing and connect with each other, and then bring this beautiful music to you. The Otterbein Summer Chorale was brought up in 2011 as an internship opportunity for current students and alumni or graduate students to have a chance to work on leading and teaching a choir from beginning to end before they went into their student teaching or before they went into their first year in the schools. And so these students will meet with Dr. Walker, our advisor, who sadly cannot be here tonight. She's out visiting family, but she sends her love, and working with this choir, she loves it so much. But she has the students, she picks us up in fall and says, all right, pick your music. How are you going to recruit them? What do you want the concert work to be? How do you perform? How do you conduct? How do you do these things for the choir by yourselves? And so it gives us that chance as students and learners to figure out, all right, do I really want to conduct? Or, you know, it is that great internship opportunity. And so we are so thankful to Dr. Walker for giving us this opportunity, and we are so excited to sing for you tonight.
hello everyone. My name is Kylie Stadler, and I am a rising senior at Otterbein University, and I am a music education major as well as a flute performance major. So I'm really blessed to be here today and to have this experience. Working with this choir has been absolutely wonderful. It's weird how many things you learn in school, and then you go to do it, and it's a lot harder when you kind of do it, right? It's crazy, right? But before we move on to our next piece, early on in the process of picking pieces for the chorale, we had three different student or former student composers present pieces to us, which was a surprise and a blessing to be able to perform something written by an Otterbein student or a community member. And we ended up choosing a piece called All the Way My Savior Leads Me by Marcia, Engel, and she's going to come tell you a little bit about it.
My name is Marcia Engel. I'm from Plain City, Ohio. I finished my second year at Otterbein as a vocal performance major and learned a lot along the way. And I wrote this piece last year. It began with the lyrics. I wanted to write a choral piece, but I didn't want to try writing lyrics from scratch because that's a lot of work. So I was searching through hymns so that I could just write new music to a piece to words that I already knew. And as I was looking, Fanny Crosby's All the Way My Savior Leads Me grabbed my attention. At the time, I was facing some big life decisions and feeling pretty overwhelmed by them. And I was seeking God's direction and leading for those decisions and trusting that He would provide a way for me. And these words just fit at the time. So a bit about it musically, it sounds like a hymn to begin with, and then it breaks out into some fun polyphony in the middle and returns to a hymn at the end. The beginning and end both speak of the security we have in Jesus as our leader, and musically I wanted to reflect that, hence the rather simple hymn. A minor section and then a lively polyphony section in the middle of the piece also lend to the meaning of the words in those sections. And thanks to Dr. Berkowitz, as I wrote that piece and struggled with it, I doubted myself different times, and she reassured me, so thank you for that. In this poem, Fanny Crosby speaks of our weakness and the uncertainty and trials we face in life. I praise God for the strength He has given me in place of my weakness. I cannot boast about anything that I have done in this short life on earth. I can only boast about what Christ has done in me. He has given me joy instead of sorrow, love instead of hate, forgiveness instead of guilt, and hope instead of despair. He offers all those things freely to each of us. And if you haven't accepted all that Christ offers you, come talk to me later. I'd love to talk with you about Jesus. He has led me all the way without fail. I can't wait to hear you all sing this piece. It's going to be so cool to hear it live. And I hope it's a blessing to all of you. Give God the glory for it.
Thank you.
before we do our last piece before intermission. And this is going to come from Fred. So,
Hi, my name is Fred Glasser. I'm a 1969 graduate of Otterbein College. And one of my classmates is back there waving at me. So glad you're here tonight. I don't know if we have any administrators or members of the music faculty here tonight, but if we do, wave at us. There's Dr. Merkowitz. Wasn't that piece magnificent?
It was.
Marcia again. Oh, yes. I just wanted to say that at the intermission, we're going to be receiving a free will offering. And what you're doing in giving to this offering, as Johnny mentioned, is you are paying forward for future opportunities for the chorale. I've been a part of this chorale since 2012 when I first found out about it. I missed the first year, haven't missed a year since. There's a lady right down here named Jamie that has been in every single one of them, and we're so proud of her for that as well. But what I want to say to you is, if you have any love for music at all, I want you to give. If you love the choir, I want you to give. If you love Otterbein, I want you to give. Because you're paying forward. You can't pay back, you pay forward, and you make it possible for us next year, if we need to buy some music, if we, when we pay our accompanists for the magnificent job, don't we have a great experience?
So this is a community choir made up for people from Otterbein as well as the community, if you didn't already know that. And it is funded by the community. And we have a really large skill range in this choir. So there are people who sing professionally in choirs in here, and there are people who have never sang in a choir that are in here this year. So I might embarrass you. If you've never been in a choir, can you raise your hand? Thank you. For our next piece, if you look in your programs, our next piece is called Five Hebrew Love Songs by Eric Whitaker. If a lot of you or some of you listen to choral music, Eric Whitaker should be a big name that pops out to you. He is a contemporary living composer who writes tons of choral music. He's very famous. He writes very beautiful pieces. And this is one of his not-so-famous pieces. And he wrote it actually with his then-girlfriend, now wife. And she he asked her for Hebrew poems. So she's Hebrew, and she gave him poems from their culture, folk poems and such, and he put this text to music. So not only are you going to hear the color and tonality of Hebrew music, but you're going to hear them speak in Hebrew. So we will be doing our first movement, the second movement, and our fifth movement.
Thank you.
from what I saw, you guys donated a lot of money. And so I know that makes us so happy that we can continue to do this program that not only benefits us, but benefits the community. So again, thank you so much for doing that. As we head into our last piece, we just want to remind you that if you are interested in joining Summer Chorale next year, please come and find Kylie or I or somebody in the choir for information about how to join us next year, because we would always love more singers. And
to the ball.
grateful for all the support in the community, and we hope you have a wonderful day. Thank you.